Thank you, Candace. And already a lot of schools, daycares, and businesses heeding the warning they've closed for the day.
Now, our Team 3 coverage continues now with WREG.com's George Brown, who's tracking all the latest closings.
Well, good morning. Earlier, I did the cha-cha slide, talking about driving now as a request for the electric slide. So we'll give a little bit of that this morning. You can tell the energy is kicking in. Markova, you like that, don't you? You might as well have a little fun if we're going to be up this early, right? Listen, we want to tell you, pretty much we think all the school closings are in. These are the ones we have right now. Shelby County, Fayette County, Marshall County, Tipton County, Tunica County, DeSoto County, and a few other schools in northern Mississippi. You're going to go to school, but they're going to let you out early. Your parents should already know that information, but we'll keep you updated on social media. Speaking of which, WREG.com right now, your school closings and other closings right there at the top, just click that red bar. You're going to find them here. We're keeping them updated as they come into us. We're also looking at MLGW. Right now, we've been looking at this. There's one person affected the whole morning so far. We're hoping it stays that way. I do want to tell you, on Twitter, we are at 3 on your side, and on Twitter right now, sorry, I'm just switching around here. I want to tell you, there is a report from the Office of Emergency Management in Memphis of a broken water main at Winchester and Riverdale. Trying to confirm that with MLGW, but this is the Office of Emergency Management that is telling us that right now. We're also looking at some of these icy pictures coming in from Arkansas. I believe this one is in Fort Smith, actually. And we've created a photo gallery on WREG.com right here on the homepage. You can look at the photos. You can also share those with us. So all that information is coming in. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter. We are at 3 on your side. Also Instagram, WREG, and of course on Facebook and WREG.com. So we're having some fun here in the morning, but it is serious business. I want you to interact with us and with me online all day, all morning. On your side, on air, online, on the go, George Brown News, Channel 3. Back to you.
Thanks for that slide.
The one school that's going a half day, DeSoto County. I think my kids aren't upset with me this morning. They think I have some control over that.
Tate County schools are getting out early too, so it's not just
just double checking.
Oh, that helps a lot, believe me, George.
You know, they're not happy, I can tell you right back, because we've had people tweeting us asking, why do we have to go to school? But administrators feel it's safe enough to go, but they're going to have to leave early and hopefully get home before anything gets bad. And, of course, you're going to tell us about that right now.
Right. And what I'm also going to say is that it's all your fault, okay? It's been my fault for so long. Now
it's his fault.
George's fault.
Me? What? Just because I'm the one person
George
early this morning?
George.Brown@WREG.com. Mm-hmm. Here in the Mid-South, we've been noticing the temperatures. They've been inching down. This has been a very slow drop. It's like that cold front came to the Mid-South. Wait a minute here. But it's still coming through.
Yeah, it is. And the temperatures are going to continue to drop throughout the day, which makes for a very dangerous situation considering all the rain we've got in the area.
Mid-20s by later in the day. Our WeatherNet 3 sites currently show some lower 30s. We're right near freezing with the north winds. First Defense Doppler 3D radar is picking up that moisture that you just saw Candace had to break out the umbrella for.